maps await players in the 1.3 update, Black Goldville and Lost Temple. The Black Goldville maps depicts the American West, with a canyon and oil refinery. The Lost Temple maps show you the summer in China. The signature feature of the map is a big temple near the river and the area around it. The new update added the Soviet heavy tank branch from tier 6 to tier 10, with the IS-4 at the top of the branch. So there are 5 vehicles. The other 4, there are T-150, KV-3, KV-4 and AST-1. Additionally, 3 premium vehicles were added. There are the American Tier 8 Super Pershing medium tank, the Soviet Su-85I tank destroyer, and the Land-Lease Valentine light tank.
New tanks. A new branch of tanks has been added to the German tech tree. Now, players will be able to drive some very famous vehicles. The Panzer IV, the Tiger Porsche, and of course, the king of the armored beasts, the Mouse Super Heavy Tank. The branch of British vehicles, and the British were the designers of the first tank, is original and doesn't look like the other branches. That's not surprising, because tank building in Britain followed its own path for a long time. The very first tank in the British tech tree is a medium tank. No other nation has a medium tank as the Tier 1 vehicle. Vehicles up to the Centurion are cruiser tanks, to use the British terminology. In real life, their main advantage was their high speed. This feature has carried over into the game. Additionally, their guns are very accurate. Average damage per shot is not high, but the rate of fire is. Classic medium tanks occupy the top of the branch. Of course, they all have their unique British features in them. These skills provide additional advantages in battle. For example, there are bonuses to mobility, camouflage, dispersion reduction, and gun firepower. Crew skills are divided into 4 groups. These groups represent types of vehicles that should be driven to take advantage of those skills. Do you want the hasty shot or soft recoil skills? Then take your light tanks into the battle. If you want robustness, drive heavy tanks. To train camouflage, roll out in a tank destroyer. The skills you have already mastered will work regardless of what type of vehicle you use in the battlefield. A new map, Winter Malinovka, was added to the game. It could be said that it brings a festive feeling, but intense battles won't let you forget why you were there. A new branch of Her Majesty's tanks has been transferred from the World of Tanks tech tree after being balanced especially for Blitz. The vehicles from tiers 1 to 4 are medium tanks. And beginning from tier 5, you can find heavy tanks. Low-tier British heavy tanks are known for their good armor and low speed. Their older brothers aren't armored this well, but they are much more mobile. What is more, all new British tanks have a high rate of fire and wonderful elevation angles. And that really means a lot if you play on mobile devices. To the new vehicles, there's now a new map. This location was made exclusively for World of Tanks Blitz and is called Castilla. This summer map, with a lot of hills and cover, will pique the interest of a lot of tankers.
Experience, maybe even premium account time or something else. All mission conditions are stated in the window. You just need to touch the icon. For example, Pyroman requires setting an enemy on fire and awards the player with 600 experience points. If you succeed in doing that, you get that extra experience bonus regardless of whether you win or lose the battle. In this window, you can also see the vehicle and tier requirements for the mission. Bear in mind that in that list, you'll only see missions for which you have at least one eligible vehicle. So, the more diverse the collection of vehicles in your garage, the more tasks you have to choose from. But there are only 3 missions available at the same time. You can choose to complete them in any order, or, if there's the possibility, you can complete them simultaneously. Some tasks can be completed in the same battle, some require several battles. Gamers is now closer to a real battle situation. Now, instead of borrowing a Sherman, you enter the tutorial in your own tank, any Tier 1 vehicle you have in your garage by default. Even the tutorial map will look different. The path from one tutorial stage to another will be more visible, and it won't finish with shooting from a certain position. After that, you can move into the open, try shooting and moving simultaneously, or have a go at fighting some AI control tanks.
The alternative branch of the German medium tanks begins with the Panzer III and Tier IV. This is a well-balanced vehicle with strong front armor, good handling, and decent armament. Starting with Tier V, the uniqueness of the branch will show more and more. Its main difference from the other German medium tanks branch is the speed and agility. The Panzer III/IV, VK30.01D, VK30.02D, Indian Panzer, and Leopard PTA have differences in their armor strength and firepower, but they are all quite fast and mobile. The Leopard 1 stands at the top of the branch. With its maximum speed of 65 kilometers per hour, it holds the title of fastest Tier 10 medium tank in the game. Maneuverability is its strong point, while its armor is not a strong point. The armor on the turret and front hull is very thin, and even the good armor angles can't compensate for this. It will be hard for the Leopard to survive under heavy fire, but it's capable of striking a Tier 6 British heavy tank with a good, quick-firing gun. This is a truly large vehicle. Of course, agility is not its strength, and its armor is quite thin. However, the TOG-2 has the highest number of hit points for its tier. The new map, Port Bay, was inspired by several coastal states of the northern USA. It's a generalized representation of their environment, landscape, and buildings. It's a mixed map. There's open space for maneuvering freely, valleys between the hills, some residential areas featuring low-rise buildings, and a dock area. The roads are wider, and there's more space. The map can be divided into two big zones, separated by a mountain range in the middle. The northern part features a river. The hilly field offers light tanks a good opportunity to use their speed. You see a lot of room to maneuver, valleys to hide in, and places to dash through enemy lines. The zone south of the mountain range is taken up by the city and docks, a great area for heavy tanks. In the central square, in front of the city hall, you'll see a base circle. The dock area in the extreme south is going to play an important strategic role. You can deliver fire to the central square and get to the flanks. So, this multifaceted map will catch the fancy of any player, regardless of their favorite vehicle class. A new Tier 6 medium tank, the Sherman Jumbo, has been added to the U.S. tech tree. This is the thickest skinned of all the Shermans. The turret and front hull are strong. The Jumbo can bounce shells like a good heavy tank, but it still has the maneuverability of a medium tank. The KV-2, a heavy tank with a giant turret, appears in Tier 6 in the Soviet tech tree. The well-armored and maneuverable KV-13, a hybrid of the KV heavy tank and the T-34 medium tank, appears at Tier 7. The Object 140 arrives at Tier 10. This will surely be one of the best medium tanks in the game. It's a versatile, agile vehicle with a well-armored turret and an excellent gun that's very accurate, even on the move. Germany receives two Panzerkampfwagen IV medium tanks at Tiers 3 and 4. These tanks are versatile and easy to master, with the usual German reliability. One of the most popular tank destroyers in World of Tanks on PC, the Jagdpanther II, also arrives at Tier 8. Its secret lies in its outstanding gun, which has high accuracy, armor penetration, and damage. This TD has almost no drawbacks. It's fast, maneuverable, and quite well armored as well. The British Churchill gun carrier occupies Tier 6. Unlike the Jagdpanther II, this TD is huge, slow, and not very well armored. However, its gun can cause serious trouble to any opponent. The clan system allows players to join groups of up to 50 players. All members of a clan are able to easily find each other, join battles together, and share common statistics. A lot of new opportunities will be appearing in the very easy to create or find a clan. The menu has a new tab. To join a clan that has already been created, just select it from a list. You can see the motto, description, percentage of victories, number of battles, vehicle tiers, and more. Submit a request and wait for the clan commander to approve it. Or you can do everything yourself. In the same menu, choose a name, unique tag, description, and motto. Then gather players under your banner. Creating a clan enables you to make decisions about its members, accept or reject requests for joining the clan, and assign ranks to clan members. As soon as you become a clan member, a unique tag appears next to your name. Back from our players, we improved two maps. The biggest changes were applied to Oasis Palms. The location was almost redesigned from scratch. The terrain is now more even. We removed the mountains on the edges. Now you can fire at anywhere on the map. The riverbed has been drained, and the urban area has become a large and strategically important zone. Teams' respawn points are now closer to the directions that you were likely to head in. For medium tanks, there are wide dunes providing enough space for accelerating and maneuvering. Heavy tanks respawn in the urban area with plenty of shelter. The Rockfield map has only begun to change. In this update, its landscape became more even with fewer bushes and trees. This will add a dynamic nature to the battles, as players will no longer have to fight against bushes. The WOT Blitz clan system continues to improve. Clan chat has been added to the game. It's now more convenient to communicate with your team. And for those who haven't tried clan battles yet, an updated search function has appeared. There, you can see the recently created clans that are actively recruiting players. Long-awaited branch of the British Tank Destroyers joins the vehicle tech tree. Now you can enjoy playing on 9 legendary vehicles, from the Universal Carrier 2 PDR to the menacing FV-215B-183. Research new vehicles and triumph in battle. Convenient to find a suitable clan. The clan characteristics are now displayed in the list of recently created clans, and the language of communication is displayed in the clan profile. Recruiting is now available. When searching for new players, a clan can set the parameters required for joining the clan. The applications from players that satisfy these requirements. The map Desert Sands has been completely reworked. The changes have been made to the town area, desert, and the general landscape. Now players have more tactical opportunities to develop attacks, and the map gameplay has been changed to be more dynamic. The battle tier for this map has been increased. Now it's available only for Tier 4 to Tier 10 vehicles. World of Tanks Blitz now has new camouflages. More than 40 kinds of summer, winter, desert, and new camouflage will provide a 4% disguise bonus for TDs, a 3% bonus to medium and light tanks, and a 2% bonus to heavy tanks. Set up an ambush, attack the enemy, and win. The system for clans gets better and better. Now, supply levels can be unlocked. This is a unique set of discounts and specials for buying vehicles, equipment, and consumables. They can be earned on the World of Tanks Blitz battlefields. For every experience point, you will get an equal amount of supply. For 1,000 experience points, you get 1,000 supply points. Easy. At first, a clan will have 4 supply levels. With each level, the bonuses will be more significant. If you want to reach the maximum level quicker, you can use your free experience and speed up the process. 6 German light tanks join the ranks with lightning speed. The legendary vehicles are getting ready to take their place in your garage. All of them are interesting in their own way with distinctive features, but special attention should be paid to the VK-16.02 Leopard, Spa-Panzer SPIC, and RU-251. The VK-16.02 Leopard enjoys decent front armor and good movement characteristics. It can reach key positions faster than others and supply its allies with important data. Spa-Panzer SPIC is a light tank with an autoloader, which can deal 1,800 hit points of damage per minute, featuring superb penetration capability. This small tank can challenge even high-tier vehicles. RU-251 is one of the fastest tanks in the game. It has good accuracy and excellent damage per minute. Changes too. One of these is Middleburg. The mountain area was increased and now has 3 avenues of approach, 2 from the enclosed area and 1 from the town. The urban area became more balanced for both teams. There are more houses and other constructions in its upper part. Players can no longer fire at the urban area from the mountain. This made gameplay more accessible. number of combat vehicles in the game is ever growing. The Soviet tech tree was reinforced with a branch of four tank destroyers. Though the Su-100M1, Su-101, and Su-122-54 cannot boast good armor, they have good accuracy and rate of fire. Object 263 crowns the branch and is a real marvel. It has strong front armor and excellent armor penetration capability. This tank destroyer is capable of holding back the enemy all by itself. Its high mobility allows it to quickly change positions for more aggressive gameplay. Consumables were completely reworked in the new version of World of Tanks Blitz. We added provisions, a new type of consumables. They are activated automatically and work throughout one battle. They will significantly influence the gameplay and players' behavior. Provisions include protective kit, standard fuel, improved fuel, and rations. The list of rations was expanded. Now your tank crew will be well fed and ready to prove themselves on the battlefields. On top of this, all the usual consumables will get the ability to reload. Tank's Blitz team never stops working on improving game locations. This time, they reworked Winter Malinovka. The influence of the mountain in the new version was considerably reduced. It became lower, while the number of hotspots in other parts of the map was decreased. The village structure changed. This region became safer for players. Houses are now placed at a more comfortable angle for tanking. A passage leading from the village to the field was added. Cover throughout almost the entire map was made symmetrical for both teams. Gameplay is now more balanced here.